In ecology, the term abandonment refers to the process when human activity or management ceases in an area, allowing nature to regain control. Following abandonment, an ecosystem undergoes natural changes in species composition and structure, often developing into a forest over time, a phenomenon called succession. Over the last century, land abandonment has increased, particularly in parts of Europe. This is driven by factors like rural depopulation, as people move to cities, and modernization in agriculture and forestry, favoring high-intensity practices and making many traditional low-intensity techniques obsolete. This change is affecting our biodiversity, and while less human intervention might seem beneficial, this isn't always the case. So how does abandonment influence biodiversity? Well, it's complicated, and it depends on what was abandoned, its context, and for how long it stays that way. For example, if abandoning monocultural management, intentionally supporting only a few species, the species that were previously actively kept out by severe human interventions, like spraying pesticides, can now establish. In this case, we would expect a large increase in biodiversity, given enough time. On the other hand, as seen with practices such as pollarding, coppicing, and litter raking, some traditional cultural landscapes already host a large number of species. Abandoning these areas can therefore have more complicated outcomes, sometimes even negative for biodiversity. This is because these human interventions can resemble natural disturbances, such as storms, grazing, wildfires, and maybe even trampling by megafauna, disturbances which were common long before human land use was widespread. Many species have evolved to thrive in these varied environments, with open clearings containing vegetation of different ages, alongside denser shaded forest areas. But as human land use has absorbed most of the naturally occurring open landscapes, the species that depend on clearings, specific floral resources, and sunlight have in many places come to rely on traditional cultural landscapes. In abandoned areas, these species often struggle and potentially face extinction. This doesn't mean that traditional management always is a better option than abandonment. Take a look at this old abandoned forest. Unmanaged forests are some of the most species-rich ecosystems on Earth. But an abandoned area needs tens, or more likely hundreds of years, to develop to this state. And importantly, they host a different set of species than traditional cultural landscapes. In many cases, restoration is necessary to get abandoned areas back into something resembling their old selves. To preserve biodiversity, it is important to conserve a variety of habitats, each supporting their own set of species, including naturally open areas, closed forests, disturbed forests, and other cultural landscapes. The aim of the project Rotate is to support the biodiversity of organisms associated with traditional forms of forest management, many of which are now abandoned or rapidly declining. Through interdisciplinary collaboration in research and practical implementation, the project seeks to revive traditional forest practices to conserve and strengthen this biodiversity. Find this interesting? Explore our other videos.